Welcome, Kingdom Fun. Today is January 9th, 2022, the second Sunday of the new year. I'm Miss Donicka, and the title of today's lesson is A Psalm of David. Let's get started. The scripture reading comes from the book of Psalm, chapter 23. And our Bible memory verse also comes from Psalm 23. Verses 1 and 6. This week's focus is God comforts us. In today's activity, David's life puzzle, we're exploring the life of David, whom we'd read about in the Old Testament. David's life is really fascinating. He went from being a lowly shepherd to being a great king. Let's see what else you know about him. We're going to fill in the crossword puzzle with the answers to the clues. We can also use the word bank for help. Let's begin with the first clue for a cross. One across, a shepherd, a king. Now, who was that? That was David. He went from being a shepherd to a king. Now, since we have the I, let's go to two down. David's country. Well, it has to begin with an I. And if we take a look at the word bank, Israel begins with an I. So two down is Israel. Okay, we can cross that one out. Now, since we have the E, let's take a look at five across. Five across has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 letters, and it also has an E as the second letter. Let's take a look at our word bank. Who can guess what is five across, which is David's city? Did you guess Bethlehem? You're correct. Let's cross it out. Next, let's move to four down. We have an E. Four down, the clue is David's father. Now we have Samuel, Jesse, and Saul left. But we know the second letter begins with an E. So that would make four down Jesse. Jesse was David's father. Cross him out. Now let's move to three going down. The clue is this prophet anointed David. Well, who anointed David? That was Samuel. Samuel anointed David. The last clue is three across. It starts with an S. And it's four letters long. The clue is king before David. So who was the king before David? Well, we only have one choice left, and that was Saul. Saul was the king before David. The focus of today's Bible reading is God comforts us. Our Bible story comes from Psalm 23, a Psalm of David. Let's take a look at the Bible timeline. David was the great-grandson of Ruth and Boaz. Samuel was a prophet who spoke for God. And Samuel anointed Saul as the first king of Israel. Now let's look at a new Bible timeline. Saul was king for 40 years. Then David became king, and he was king for 40 years. Now, what are the first five books of the Bible in the New Testament called? Those are called the books of law. What are the books from Joshua through Esther? Those are the books of history. Today, we'll pick up God's story in the book of Psalms. The books from Job all the way to Song of Songs are books of poetry. These books help us worship God. Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd. I lack nothing. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. He refreshes my soul. He guides me along the right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I will fear no evil. For you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely your goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Let's imagine a shepherd boy in the hills with his sheep. He is listening for the sounds of other animals, like wolves, that may try to harm his sheep. Even though he's alone, he sings to praise God. Let's pretend that we are David, singing to God the song that would later become a Psalm 23. Maybe, being in the hills, there's an echo. Each time after I read one line, all of you will repeat the line as if you were echoing the words. Let's begin with the first line of Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd. I lack nothing. Repeat. He makes me lie down in green pastures. Repeat. He leads me beside quiet waters. He refreshes my soul. He guides me along the right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I will fear no evil. For you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely your goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Great job. Psalm 23 is a passage of scripture that people often read when they're upset or scared or needing comfort. The shepherd's rod and staff were used to guide, support, protect, and rescue his sheep. David found comfort in knowing that God does those things for us. He guides us, he supports us, he protects us, and he rescues us. That's how God comforts us. The Bible memory verse comes from Psalms 23, the first and also the sixth verse. The Lord is my shepherd, I lack nothing. Surely your goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. How do you feel knowing that no matter what troubles or worries come your way, God is your shepherd? He is always there for you, taking care of you and your worries and your troubles. This week, we have three review activities. First, in comforting words, read Psalm 23 again, then choose the correct answers. Next, we have shepherds and sheep. Fill in the blanks with the word shepherd or sheep to make the sentences correct. Last, in God guides me, the word search, look forward, backward, up and down to find the words in Psalm 23, verse 3. He refreshes my soul. He guides me along the right path for his name's sake. Remember to go to www.nearpod.com to complete this week's review activities. Our class code is 74G. I-9. I repeat, 74G-I-9.
Thanks for joining us again this week. Remember, we love you in Kingdom Fun. Let's end with a word of prayer. Lord, thank you for being our shepherd. Thank you for taking care of our needs as well as our wants. Thank you for leading and guiding us in the way that we should go. Just like sheep, thank you for keeping us safe, restoring our peace, and helping us in our time of need. You have never left us, Lord. You are always there for us to depend on. Thank you for hearing us when we call. Lord, you are our comforter, our provider, and our protector. We honor you and praise you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Now, let's look at this list of ways that you can share God's comfort with others. You can do that by being a good friend, praying with others, listening to them, encouraging them, reminding them how much God loves them, and also reading scriptures with them. This week, I challenge you to choose at least one way that you can share God's comfort with others, or you can come up with one on your own. Have a blessed week, guys. Bye.